70% of the population in Bhutan are small-scale farmers, and a large part of them are doing animal husbandry. Like here, as you can see, I'm surrounded by yaks. Please don't attack me. So, thing is, my camera trap and corridor 8, it's just there. Just there, like 1 kilometer away from that. So we are right on tiger territory. Muzambo. Maggie, you mean Emmanuel? Is there any sort of problem with the big cat here? Do you know if people are sometimes like killing tigers to prevent them from attacking? If your yak is killed by a tiger, then you will get some sort of financial compensation for that. The problem is that this specific fund was really working here in Bhutan, but it's been out of money for the last 4 years. But the good news is going to be very soon put back in place.
There's a lot of problem in poaching in Bhutan, but the situation now is improving because more and more rangers coming up. We are removing lots of snares.
So what I'm trying to do here with the camera traps is not only to get an image of tigers, a close-up of tigers. I'm trying to make an image where when you look at it, you immediately understand that this is a wild tiger in its natural habitat, in its forest in the Himalaya. So that's the plan, that's what I'm trying to do. It's very frustrating because it's been almost a month.
Nothing.
We have nothing. And I'm starting to be really stressed. I can't believe that. I'm super happy right now.
Oh, one, two, three.
Wow.
Very nice.
Yalla man.
Very
All
big.
No,
very big. Very big. Big.
So this is how this incredible first month in Bhutan is ending. Tomorrow I'm leaving, going back to France because I have another big project going on there. It's called Baby. We are expecting our first baby. So I will come back here in 2 months. So I left all the camera trap in the field. Hopefully in 2 months I will have maybe more images. I really hope so. Thank you so much for following this adventure and see you in 2 months.